You are on the air.
So I have to apologize that I have to fix the proof of the isomorphism between the associated with the W-algebra and the functions. So this is the isomorphism of the I'm really glad that the video tape was not broken. So I have to use a Frenkel density, so we have the decomposition of the complex, and so that the algebra is more to the homology of the smaller complex C minus. And this, I didn't explain explicitly, but this complex has only finite dimensional homogeneous component. And you can, because this is a vertex of algebra, you can consider the corresponding filtration. And then because of the finite dimensionality, the corresponding filtration is regular and gives rise to a convergence because of the finite dimensionality. So if you compute the associated group homology of the associated gradient, it's not difficult to see if it's isomorphic to the homology of associated gradient of the whole space if you did the exercise in the previous lecture. So this is actually isomorphic to the homology appearing as E super. So we can see the desired isomorphism. So today I'd like to so today I restrict myself to SL entities. So one could consider the unique simple quotient of a double algebra. So basic problem here is to describe a two-algebra for the simple quotient. So the problem basic problem is to describe a two-algebra in the simple quotient, which is a quotient of the algebra of the universal one, which is isomorphic to the center of the enveloping algebra. So this is a commutative algebra. And so simple modules are described by this quotient term. So to but the problem here is that we don't know the lambda bracket. Here we can express the generators explicitly, but we cannot really compute lambda bracket. It's too complicated. So we need some, we need to do something. We have to avoid an explicit derivation to describe lambda. So to avoid
you said we know explicit generators, you mean via the Miramar?
Via the Miramar, but there's no closed formula for the lambda bracket, at least at this moment, so we don't know how to know.
So what we are always considering principal equal.
first of all, so let me please. The result I explained today holds for all. So I consider the category of module of a universal vertex algebra. It's the same as the category of smooth G-hat model. Then if you take an object here, and then we can consider corresponding topology. So if you take an element here, then if you tensor with a fermionic Fox space, this is a naturally module of a VKG tensor. And so Q0 acts here, and the square equals to 0. So this makes this space a complex, and you can consider corresponding. And this is a module of a double algebra by the commutator relation, as I
what is superscript? Super, sub zero?
Q.
Q.
No, the superscript.
Zero.
Superscript.
Square equals.
Square.
But then you should remove square. It's the next line.
It's called.
In HZ.
Cohomology.
It's the last line.
So the action here induces the action of the algebra here because the Q half of zero is a zero. It minus a zero. And by the commutator formula, you see that the action here is here. So this corresponds to the factor of the category for the VTG module to the category of the module of the algebra. And we'd like to study the module of a double algebra through this one. Since this category is the same as the category of sumus.
This is with upper K, but we want lower K, correct?
Yeah, we want to deduce something from lower K by studying this one. So because this category is the same as this category of sumus representation G-hat of level K, as a full subcategory, we have the usual category O of G-hat. So this is a category O of G. So this is a G-hat module of level K, which admits weight space decomposition. This is a weight space of weight lambda, and lambda has to satisfy something. This is the usual. Maybe I assume that this is right. This is the usual category O of G. And I consider a smaller plus of category. So this is an object on which G, which sits inside G, acts as a machine. So it's a direct sum of finite elementary.
Lambda 1, lambda n, c. H.
H hat star.
H
star. So this is a hat term of and I will take QI. And we restrict the, so we study the restriction of this factor to this subproduct. And so it's enough to consider this category because VKG and V lower KG belongs to this category. And so I forgot to mention one beautiful thing. So you have this diagram. Maybe I just consider. So as I said, there's a diagram here, and to study the functor, it's suggestive to the functor which induces on this classical object. So I start. With the describing the functor.
What's the first name? It's a
Reis-Kovel. So I will study the functor which induces this category, this function. The Poisson setting. So, in order to describe the classical counterpart of this functor, I need to include some notion. So let R be Poisson algebra. Then Poisson R module. There's a notion of a Poisson module, which is a R module in the usual commutative sense, equipped with by linear mode, which makes algebra module over R. So R is both commutative algebra and D algebra. And the Poisson R module has to be a module over R as a ring, and also has to be a module over R as a D algebra. And you have to satisfy a certain compatibility condition. Yes.
Left.
Yeah, left. A1, A2M is A1, A2M plus A2, A1, M. And A1, A2M is A1, A2M plus A2, A1. So this is about that. And the example so I explained Poisson structure on function on this stuff, which is coming from the E bracket of D. The same as
the Poisson module.
Poisson module. It is the same as the CD super module as a ring. I mean, as a in the you can use a computer and equipped with the V-algebra action of G satisfying so the element of G can be also considered a subspace of element of CD star by identifying its CD symmetry algebra. So this Poisson bracket is defined. So it's quite a user. I introduced this notion in the foreign so if you have a particular algebra and the M of three modes, then I define M bar to be a subspace span of so this is user C space. So this is a statement, this is a Poisson R V module. So in this notation this is the same as we have same form. So A bar M bar is a minus one product. And E algebra action is given by 0 of 2. Minus one product.
Yeah, but the internet.
It's zero. Zero. Yeah. So I define one problem from the previous data. So a volume module M is strongly infinitely generated if M bar is finitely generated over R2. In the usual associated. Then, so in this case,
so it's finally, if M bar is finally generated, not as a Poisson model, but as a model.
As our computer. In this case, because it is finitely generated module, we can define the support of this module as a sub-variety of associated variety, which is defined by a spectrum of the physics itself. And for this associated variety of motion.
Is it obvious that if it's strongly finitely generated, then it's finitely generated?
It's a definition.
No, the definition is that M bar is finitely generated.
Yeah.
Why M is finitely generated?
No, it's a definition of the strongly finitely generated.
Right. But does it this imply that M is finitely generated?
Yeah. I'm going to stay.
That's what I said.
So as Alberto said, so we have the following. M is an object of this parabolic category. Then M is finitely strongly generated depend on over VGC. If and only if M is finitely generated over G. This is I think your question. And the proof is again exercise. It's not difficult.
Sorry, what does the FSG mean?
Finitely strongly generated.
FSG.
Even though before you called it strongly finitely generated. So it should be SFG, not FSG.
Which is the correct way to say. Strongly finitely generated.
So SFG, not FSG.
Finite dimensional weight spaces.
Sorry?
This category is in finite dimensional weight spaces for L1.
Yeah.
But if it's not in K,
if
it's not in KFK,
it's not in KFK, I think it's okay.
What?
For example, Brown was a non finite system. Only white module is
finite.
Now, I define the category H bar as a good subcategory of a Poisson CG star.
It is what HC in
Alexandra. V-algebra fraction of G is essential for local effect. And it's easy to see that if N is object of K of K, then M bar is object of H bar. So we have the factor which sends object of K of K to H bar by sending N to M bar, which is a right integer. Because it's a Now, if you have an object here, more ordinary, you are given a Poisson CG star module, then if you tensor with, maybe I should write. So this is a Poisson CG module. Where CG was a tensor product of CG star is solid. It's a classical for the algebra, which is a super Poisson. So if you had an adjoint of the so we have the Fourier element Q bar such that adjoint of Q bar equals 0, and this relation holds among this 2. So this becomes a complex, and we can consider a corresponding homomorphism. And here the Poisson module structure over this induces a Poisson module structure of A0 of CG which was isomorphic to a function of the slice. So we get the functor which sent which from H bar to the category. So this has a trivial Poisson structure now. So I just write just a module about this. And we send N to I'm using notation, and I also write this H0. So E to H0. And so if M is the object of,
why do you need to start with Harishanda?
Because if you take an element from KLK, the M bar is a object.
Mm-hmm.
Later, I use this condition to derive some values. Yeah, so if you have an object of k, so m bar it was object of and then cn so cn was m tensor maybe I didn't define but if you define this, then so this is a module of CK G hat D, which was a tensor product of affine vertex algebra. Then what's this? So CM bar is a module of so this is algebra of this vertex algebra, which is a tensor product of these two. It's algebra, so G bar, which is a C G. And so this is, as you can easily see, just a tensor product of this of the space I can consider. So what I want to say is that so a cohomology induced.
You mean a CK
object,
not BK? CK. No, C of M bar.
So the, if you consider the cohomology induced on the shifted space, so this is exactly the cohomology I define there. M bar M tensor C bar which is so if you consider a module instead of an algebra, so by cohomology, we get a functor too.
So, Q0 does not act in C of M bar.
Sorry?
Q, the rest of it is something weird. Either you put bar on top or M. No, but Q1.
So Q hat is an element of here, and the zero mode is a differential operator here.
On C of M, not on C of M bar.
Not C M, but induced, it preserved the C2 space. So it acts also on this space.
So you have to get put a bar.
So the equation becomes stable. So if you take a C2 space, we get the object here, and then we get the
C2 means taken portion for the
yes, so by C. This was isomorphic to the function of this.
the theorem of states of the current. So if you have the cohomology vanishing for any object of each bar.
This quotient xi minus the
chi xi. So xi is a basis of upper hypotenuse upon zero, and the chi xi just a pairing with if other hypotenuse. And so H0M has the same form. So M over this is so S admits system action contracting lift, as I explained in the first lecture, and this is invariant of the system action. Meaning that it is a gradient. Now, let N be a set of nilpotent elements in G. Then, so this is as well known, the set of nilpotent elements is a zero set, zero locus of the positive part of the invariant polynomial. So this has a structure of algebraic variety. Oh. And of course, if which was element like this belong to this variety. And of course, this is invariant under the action of G, a joint action of G. And so M contains the orbit of this nilpotent area. And partly that this is dense, this orbit is dense in this nilpotent quant. So the M equal to the closure, that's the closure. So exercise again is the following. So show an intersection of nilpotent cone and a set of companion matrices consists of only one element F, which is this. And this exercise is immediate if you have done from this this description if you have done exercise in the past. Now so the theorem implies, so in particular this one. Implies that the image is non-zero, then of course support of is non-empty, and because so the theorem applies.
Let's see of S support over.
Sorry.
What is the index of support?
CS.
CS.
So this is a trivial statement, and this is same as a support. Of this contains element if by systems. Because this variety is invariant under the action of a system which is contracting to F. So it has to contain element F. But because M, and this is the same as the theorem says, this is the same as support of CG. So M with this S contains. So of course, S contains, this the support of M contains. So F is an element of S, so if this contains, if this has to contain. But because this is M is G invariant and closed. So this is equivalent to support of M contains the closure of the orbit of F, which is equal to the nilpotent quant.
Yeah, because so the adjoint action of this Hausdorff category of Hausdorff category is in integral. So this support is G equal. So it has to contain the orbit object under its closure. And by the following fact, this closure is equal to the whole. Criterion for the H0M to be noted. And moreover, if support of this module is exactly the Nilpotent form, then support of H0M is just a point wave which follows from the exercise. So this is the intersection and which is exercised by A. So H0M is finite. If you start with a finite, if M is finite generally, and so the finite dimensionality of the image, if you have an object whose support is exactly the Nilpotent form, you get some finite dimension module for the function. And because sheets of finite, or this topographic operator algebra is analog to finite dimension algebra, now this is going to be the criterion. Find this adaptation. So I'm going to use that. But before that, I want to explain the functor which induces here. So I want to quantize this construction. So quantization means by I replace CD star by enveloping algebra of C. And the natural the quantization of the H bar is a category of the Kac-Wakimoto algebra. So H will be the category of full subcategory used by module. Add G, whose add G action is this extension. So this category is a quantization of ETC bar in the following sense. So then, every finitely generated object M of HC admits a good grade
that is a filtration. Increasing filtration, which is compatible with the filtration of UG. So that means UP of G, if QN URG included in UP plus Q plus R. If Qp plus Q plus R n. And the commutator of have minus 1 into so Q plus minus 1. And if you have a such a filtration,
so such a filtration is called, for some reason, grading.
Sorry?
Well, it's called grading.
It's a filtration, it's not a grading.
It's a filtration.
Why is it called good grading?
But I haven't explained what good, how good, sorry, good filtration. So this, I just explained what filtration. What kind of filtration we need. And so if you have a such filtration, the associated variety is a Poisson CG star. So if you have a bimodule, filtered bimodule, and the M is a filtered module of a bimodule, then it's associated graded a Poisson module of the associated. And that a good monition means the finite. And so,
that so definition for the good filtration?
Good filtration means that it's good means that it's
finite. Okay, that's the difference.
Yeah, by the way, so this is a usual usage of good filtration, but D uses the good filtration for another meaning. So it's a
what is it? What good stands for?
Good means
Ah, good means an associate.
This is finite.
Right.
Fine.
Fine.
So if you have so the statement that the associated gradient of the object of HC is an object of HC bar. This is easy. Because it is almost, so because a joint action was same simple, so if a joint action is here, it was same simple. So it's
Oh, and so if you have a finitely, if you have a such a filtration, we can define the variety of this module as a support of this associated variety. Maybe I should put it here. And so it's a priori depends on the good filtration, but it's known that this is independent of the choice of good filtration. So you have a, you can define functor from the category or from each to the category of homogeneous center by sending n to H0 or functors in the same way. You just quantize everything.
Is exactly
the ideal is generated by the positive part of the invariant polynomial, and so it's isomorphic to the function. So in this case, variety of IUG over I lambda is exactly the important form. And hence, and so, in H0 of UG over I lambda is finite dimensional. And in fact, in this case, just one dimensional. Okay, I make a break here. After break, I explain. I start with explaining this construction to the Zuse binomial. So what is easy to see is that if M is object of K and K, then it's this bimodule is object of bimodule. So you have this functor. And also those algebra of complex, those bimodular of a complex is a tensor product of those bimodular of a fermion. And this is the same as the critical algebra. View that the module, let's say. So, the homology, because also this differential operator Q hat 0 acts, preserves this quotient space. So, it acts on this space, and so you can consider the complex, and you can cross the corresponding homology, and I don't know how to write this. And so, staying under this is exactly the isomorphic to the complex I consider there. So, this is the tensor product of this, this space is I just consider which I denoted by it is a we had a suggestion from this algebra to this Poisson algebra. So, and such a Poisson are three modules. And the statement is that there is a surjective homomorphism or Poisson three modules which send in bar to the associated gradient of the line.
Is it still the same line?
And moreover, and this is an isomorphism if M is free over UGT inverse. Another lemma. So this is exactly just analog of the statement I made for user algebra. It's just the same proof applies for the modules. And if n admittative in W best, you can also show this lesson. So if m is the K of K, and suppose such that free, this is free over, suppose that it's a free over UG T inverse T inverse, then this size of this map is actually by doing the same thing. So I think I have explained this diagram slide, but I don't have time to explain the induced functor of the Poisson vertex. But you can still, it's straightforward to consider corresponding functor to Poisson, the module of a Poisson vertex algebra. And you get the module of a function on the half space of the slices, and which has a nice property. As I understand this category here, okay. so the functor. Yeah. Is exact. The second statement is that the you can consider bar of H0n, which is, so this is a module of, so this is a R of H0, R of WK, G module, which is the same as the module of R. The statement is that this is isomorphic to H0 of M bar, which I introduced in the beginning. So this is so in other words, this unitary Sokolov reduction functor commutes with this C2 functor. So if you look at this diagram, and you have the commutative. That's the statement. This was a support. And this is support. But because this equals to a to zero for in bar. By the integral result, this is the isomorphic equal to the intersection of this isomorphic. This equals to the Viking group. Now suppose of C is that that is and this is behind. The third statement is that if you look at the factor, it also commutes with the so if you look at the factor
fact, here and here and here and here is also convex.
Let us see.
So you need a corollary of the second statement. You'll be fine. So if L is a quotient of the universal affine vertex algebra, then the first second statement that if L is a quotient of universal affine vertex algebra.
Sorry, you are h zero for what's the bracket integral?
The
next one.
Integral. Because integral representation is seems to be fine, so the variety is and then the image is this way, the seems to be fine. Then this is L. The image of L is the variety of the L is exactly the same.
If not,
not sure. So the. This if and only if the variety of L is so this is a condition. But
no, it's so VLG is just a kind of basic module of L of L of somehow that's not one and two contradict each other because you said if it's integral representations then
zero.
H0 should be zero because
yeah.
What is the next step? Is it?
So the variety of simple quotient, the variety of simple quotient is the exact nilpotent form, then the image is zero. But the integral representation does not satisfy this function because the variety is zero. It has to be B. But not so.
So in particular, some of the admissible.
Yeah, that's what I want to maybe tomorrow.
So if you find such a simple vertex algebra, you get this quotient. And if you look at so integral representation does not give any not trivial vertex algebra, but if you consider someone who has admissible representation, you get that you say it's a four-point interval as well. That's what I hope to tomorrow. But today so maybe I give a stricter proof of first thing, admitting one and two, because I think this is the most logical. So what is needed to see that there is a natural map from Zuse algebra of H0M to H0 of Zuse algebra. So we have, I show on a first surgery. So we can assume the main assume. So this map induces this is a bimodule homomorphic over Zuse algebra of double algebra, which is a homomorphic. So this induces map between associated today. You look at the corresponding marks of the associated gradient, and this associated gradient is isomorphic to H0 of group of 2M.
But this is a property of this function. And so I think I'm not sure I explained, but for this function, it's probably. So you have to show, we need to show, so the sufficient, sufficient. Show this is surjective. So you have a surjection from M bar to associate gradients with time. As I explained in lemma today. And this induces surjection. So this is in category H bar. And because this factor was exact, this induces a surjection from H to 0. And by the second statement, this is isomorphic to H0 bar of H0m. And the bar, we have the isomorphism of bar of this is 0. And this map was here. And it's easy to check that this diagram. So because this is isomorphic and this is surjection, so this must be surjection. So this must have been surjection. So it's associated with. So as I said, now I proved the injection also. And so because I'm assuming that M is finitely generated, there exists an object in KLK such that free over U the inverse and the surjective homomorphism to P to M. And I do not discover that M.
What is M for M?
Sorry. I state the main design is an exact sequence in this category such that P is free over. Because Zeus factor is right exact, so this induces this exact sequence. Which is exact the sequence in the category of Hashanah life. And because H0 was exact, so this induces exact sequence.
abstract except that the long exact sequence stops. You can put exact zero because of this right definition.
By definition. And so, on the other hand, if you apply this sequence the joint field support of reduction directly, we get an exact sequence. So by the first statement, which is the exact statement of the server. Have this exact sequence. And again, by the right exactness of this function, we have the exact sequence. So we have the commutative diagram where this is eta and this is eta and this is eta m and they all these are subjects and this is eta. And then our claim is that eta p is an isomorphism. So this is because p is a free of this Minicourse subalgebra. So the surjection from this module to this bimodule is isomorphism. By applying, we get the isomorphism between H0 of T bar and H0 of T. And by second statement, this is HT of bar of H0 of T. And I have the suggestion from here to T of and this is which way? So this not in this is so this is isomorphic to good of H0 of P. I already used this isomorphic somewhere. This is a statement for the finite dimensional function. And the map here
from here to here.
Yeah. Somewhere, so the direction is opposite here. So I have a map from downwards. And this is a rule of eta. And all, because all of this isomorphism, all this is selection, and both of this must be an isomorphism. So eta p is isomorphism, so which implies eta m is isomorphism. I wrote the direction in the opposite direction, so I made a confusion. But so it turned out that the string is so profound that it is very nice and very convenient. I use this function to obtain the rational amount of this equation. But minimal series. I don't think I can. I just go through the algorithm.
Next time is Friday.
Oh, yeah, right. I start with this representation theory of atomicity. So we need